know, boys, I don't want to get shot, but this is a mistake. I work for Cornwall Kerosene and Tar, Mr. Leviticus Cornwall.
Oh, great.
So you know him?
Who doesn't?
I hear he's rich enough to share the wealth. And not miss it too much.
Oh, he'll miss it.
Okay, why don't you check out around the back?
Arthur, help me out here.
Next time I'm just gonna play catch up. Next time I'm just gonna ride forward. Forget that. Forget Jenna.
Everyone,
course, you keep watching now.
Sure.
Well, we get some rest. All right. Let's try and get out of here.
Hey, shit.
Absolutely. Shut up, old man.
Look, I was just trying to...
Shut up. Damn.
I hate it. Let's just keep this going. See what happens.
Is this your place?
Kinda.
You didn't hear nothing? Why don't you just tell me, Parker, what you heard?
Tell me what you heard.
I don't... Some noises out by the barn a while ago.
Hey, me.
All right. Come forth. Look. Go check out the barn.
Sir.
Inside, I'll go around the back.
Come on.
Thank you.
quiet and move.
Trying to fight the KKK. What the f-
a student of the history of the region, and...
I ain't the one to speak to. Try Master Bo. Think he's down there by the wood store. Boy's got all the time in the world.
Okay, fella.
Safe with me.
What secret?
I got a secret of my own.
Are you secretly normal?
Excuse me?
Never mind.
Thing is, I don't care if you kill the whole lot of us and the Braithwaites.
I don't want to kill anyone.
I love her, you know.
Love who?
Penelope. But it's impossible.
Love tends to be complicated.
She's a Braithwaite. I'm Bo Gray, son of Tavish Gray, nephew of Lee Gray, the sheriff, grandson of old Murdo Gray. We Greys have been loyal to the state and murderous to the Braithwaites for so long now, no one can even quite explain why. Beyond blind loyalty and stupidity. I'm supposed to be loyal to some nonsense while she's amazing. She's like a woman from the future. She's like tomorrow, if tomorrow turns out fine.
Well, I'm sorry for your predicament.
Would you help?
I don't want to get involved in gang feuds. Seems unseemly.
I'll pay. I've got money. We Greys, we've always got money. No brains mind but money.
Well, in that case...
I know she loves to sit out in the gazebo on the edge of the Braithwaite property. Take her this letter and this bracelet, please.
Penelope Braithwaite?
Why, yes, I am.
I've got a letter for you.
Oh.
And a gift.
A letter and a gift. Well, we don't even know each other.
Well, it's not from me. It's from,
From Bo. Bo, he is so...
strange?
Yes, he's a little strange, but also so human. The rest of our families are stuck in the Dark Ages. Well, I don't know, cave people, perhaps. Bo's different. But if they find out, they'll kill him and send me to live someplace awful, like Ohio. Have you ever been to Ohio, sir?
No.
Well, neither have I, but my uncle has a factory there. He was sort of the black sheep on account of having left. But now they tolerate him because he's a vicious snob. Families are... there's something else. You got a family, sir?
No, not really.
Well, they tolerate him because of the money. But me, with my ideas above my station, they can't stand.
That sounds pretty complicated. I don't know quite what to say.
Well, nothing to say, except I hope they all rot. I don't. Well, maybe a bit. But here, if you see Bo again, will you give this to him?
Sure.
Thank you.
You got my money?
Sure. Did she give anything? For me?
Yes.
Might I have it?
Sure. It'll cost you. I can't be bothered. Here, take it.
Thank you, Arthur. Thank you. My God. What a woman. This'll get her killed for sure.
What?
Women's suffrage. Around here, they don't even like men voting. Bring back the monarchy, given half the chance. Progress is a dirty word in these parts. Unlike incest.
Excuse me?
I don't want to marry my cousin Matilda. I want to marry Penelope. But they're gonna... They'll kill her at one of those rallies they're holding. They've done it before. Mister, you gotta help.
No, I'm afraid I don't want no part of it.
I'll pay. My family. We've still got some money.
Fine. Just no more running around with letters.
Thank you. Come on. We better get going.
Here.
Know that.
Do something, please.
What? Fight this mob?
We must begin.
They need me alive.
This is no laughing matter, sir. They need protecting from certain elements. Mostly my family. Penelope, I beg you.
I'll tell you what. Your friend here can drive the wagon for us. It'll allow us to shout all the louder. Miss Calhoun, my friend here says he can drive the wagon.
Well, Olive Calhoun, normally I like to drive myself, but today I feel like a man joining us sends the right message.
Well, I ain't never been in a protest march before, madam.
Well, just treat us like the sheep and the folks attacking us like the wolves, and I'm sure you'll feel right at home. Shall we go? All right, ladies. We know our song is a good one, and we know our cause is a pure one.
Yes, ma'am.
Let liberty reign!
We're mothers, wives, housekeepers, and daughters. We cook the food and we fetch the
now,
water.
Now, take us down Main Street, right through town to the steps of the Bank of Roads,
Mr. What was your name?
Arthur Morgan.
Very good, Mr. Morgan. Not too quick, and not too slow. We need them to hear our voice.
Well, they'll hear it, all right.
Very good. Mr. Morgan, are you an old friend of the movement?
Oh, just a driver, Mrs. Calhoun. Maybe a shotgun messenger if it comes to it. I hope it won't.
Our message will be delivered peaceably, Mr. Morgan. You can keep your shotgun to yourself. Stay on Main Street. It's a left up here, Mr. Morgan. Look at these people. It's about to get exciting. I can feel it.
I believe you might be right.
Good day, Sheriff. I trust you'll make sure it's a peaceful assembly.
Damn us all with these sin! You'll damn us all!
all of us.
Yay!
For today is the day we begin to live as equals.
Equals!
Ah! Yes, equal, sir. Fair and equal.
This is unnatural. This is nonsense. Yeah!
Fair, equal, and free, just as the Founding Fathers intended.
Yeah! Founding Fathers, not Founding Mothers, you silly old goat.
What are you doing here, boy?
Keep your voice down. I'm trying to listen to the speech.
Hello, darling cousin. Don't you ever speak to me like that.
What are you doing here?
Listening, I suppose.
Go help Bo. His cousin is a moron. Stop them from ruining the speech.
You need to learn yourself some manners, cousin.
Haven't you got anything better to do?
Oh, you always was.
Bo, weren't we just leaving?
Who the hell is this?
Follow me, Ronnie.
Or what? You'll hit me?
Oh, come on.
Sir, can you not see how idiotic you are?
Come on, Bo. Let's go. Quick now.
We gotta go before they think twice. Follow me. I know a place. It's an old battlefield no one goes to.
Speeches. I ain't voted before, but kind of getting hot for voting rights.
I don't know whether to take you seriously, Mr. Morgan. My cousins are my primary concern right now. If everyone knows about Penelope and me...
Everyone knows about Penelope and you. I know about Penelope and you, and I've been here all 10 minutes. The sooner it's out, the sooner it's resolved.
The sooner it's dealt with, you mean?
We're dealt with.
Our families, the Greys and the Braithwaites, we bury our secrets, and we bury them deep.
Your secrets and your treasure?
You know, Catherine Braithwaite's got a daughter. No one's seen her in years. She weren't right, you know, and Penelope said...
I ain't heard about daughters. I heard about gold.
But Yankee gold? I fear that's just a story, Mr. Morgan. But I don't know.
This is awful.
Nobody died. Ain't that awful?
My cousins are vindictive bastards. My brothers are vindictive bastards. My cousins are worse.
They started it.
I know, but...
You should leave.
I will, as soon as I have enough money. With my family, we have money, but I don't.
Is your family very rich?
Yes, well, I believe so. But they keep me out of the discussions. I have more of a artistic temperament, so...
Oh, is that what you call it?
Yes. Oh, you made a joke. I really love her. I do.
Well, stick around. Maybe you can die for her as well.
I thought you were trying to make me feel better.
I gotta go.
Me too. Oh, damn! I'm gonna be late. My uncle is quite as bad as you would imagine. Here, your payment. Thank you. Excuse me.